नित्यानंदेश्वर सदाशिव समारंभाम्। नित्यानंदेश्वरी आदिशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, shrimahans, mahans, tanedar, kotari, visitors, viewers, everyone sitting with us all over the world, with my love and respects. Today Mahasadashivoham, continuous education program, to have super conscious breakthrough, to manifest all the powers, one of the important principle you need to understand, the powerful cognition you need to manifest is intensity is continuity, continuity is intensity. Intensity can never lose its continuity. If something is continuing, it can never vary in its intensity. Intensity and continuity is one and the same. Listen, why you don't realize intensity is continuity? Listen, now this is a very important understanding. Giving legitimacy to your confusions as facts and deciding, thinking these are facts further in your life is called confusion. Listen, I'll repeat maybe once more. Maybe I'll put it in this way so you can understand. Giving legitimacy to your confusion as conclusions. You have some confusion and you think, oh, this is the fact, truth. Based on that, you start deciding further. That is what I call depression or you can use all bad words. Dash, 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 dash. All bad words. Listen carefully. The moment you think your confusion is a fact or truth, you give legitimacy to it, which is the worst danger you do to you. And giving legitimacy to your confusion, making it as a subject to study, is psychology. No, it's not. Psychology is nothing but giving legitimacy to your confusion and evolving a subject out of it and creating new theories called subconscious, unconscious, unsubconscious, subconscious, suburban conscious. Psychology is nothing but giving legitimacy to your confusions. Listen carefully. There is only two things. One, body. Second, consciousness. That's all. There is no such thing as psychology. Your confusions need to be cleared, not analyzed or legitimized. One of the best answer Ramana Maharshi gave. Somebody goes and asks Ramana Maharshi, what's the meaning of dreams? He said, even waking state does not have a meaning. Stupid fellow. What waking state has a meaning? What is the meaning of dreams? Even waking state does not have a meaning. What do you mean by asking meaning to the dream state? Confusions given legitimacy by a confused person to exploit all the confused people and to produce more and more confused people. So he will continue to have confused clients and customers is psychology. And you also create people who believe in the principles of psychology and decide to hide what they diagnose as their sickness and try to help others in the name of treatment is called psychologists. All psychologists and psychiatrists believe they are sick very strongly. They strongly believe they are sick. And the moment you give legitimacy to your confusion as a fact or truth, you are gone. You are gone. Understand, I'll give you some of the fundamental understandings about life, because I want to continue on physics, chemistry and biology of the cosmos. I want you to understand breathing space of the consciousness may look independently alive but does not have its own life. For example, after you switch off the fan, few minutes it will run, few seconds it will run. That does not mean it is now empowered. Same way, your thoughts after leaving the consciousness may be alive for a few seconds till it reaches your body, but does not have independent life. All your confusions, when you start believing they are facts and give the legitimacy of the truth, after that, the sufferings you generate, nobody can solve it. That is the worst thing. Because it is imaginary. Nobody can sort it out. See, today I was talking to one of my Adinavasi. I was explaining to him, convictions are different. Conclusions are different. For example, I tell somebody, you are my cook. You cook and I am going to eat that every day. Yes, that is conviction about my trust on that person and that person's integrity to me and all that. Then, in the food, maybe less salt. Of course, I eat without salt. So, in the food, some problem. Something is overboiled or less boiled. I may question their action, just the conclusions they arrived during their action, but I am not questioning the conviction. Understand, two are different. I am not questioning the person's identity as my cook, my integrity, my trust to that person or that person's integrity to me. But I will continue to question any conclusions they arrived during the cooking. One of the biggest problem human beings have, if I question their conclusions, they are not able to separate their conclusions and their convictions. So they take it personally and think, oh, my conviction is questioned, my fundamental is questioned. Then they feel insecure. Understand, this is especially for the Adinavasis who get to work with me directly. I always question only your conclusions, not the conviction we both have about each other. It's my conviction about you. You are still living in Kailash. After all, this whole Kailash is complete my freedom. Who lives here and who does not live here? Me letting you live here is what is the solid proof of my conviction about you. I question your conclusions so that you will come to better conclusions in future. That's all. I want you to come to better conclusions. I gave one example of cook. But I was not talking to my cook. That is different. I'm giving you one example. Yes. Whether it is a temple, Gurukul, construction department, or the purchase department, or kitchen, or security, in any department, I will question about your conclusions so you can come to better conclusions. But I will never question our conviction about each other. Understand, conclusions, many times you come to a conclusion putting your confusion as a fact or truth. When you put your confusion as a fact or truth and come to any conclusion, that is what I call destroying your life because of temporary mood swings or upset. I always tell people, don't do big damages to yourself because you are temporarily upset. Understand, only when you start falsely believing your confusions as facts, truth, or conclusions, your intensity and continuity starts breaking. Listen. Your intensity starts coming down only when you put your confusions as truths or facts. Confusions are neither truths nor facts. That is why I am telling you, without bothering about your mood, physically doing the rituals is the best way. Don't think you will have a flowery, romantic, la lulu mood, then you will start your puja. No, that's never going to happen. Start your puja, the la lulu mood will become permanent. Many fellows say, when I get a loving, devoted mood, I will start puja. That is a criminal fellows. Cheats. That's absolutely cheating. You know you are never going to get that mood. Or you blackmail God, you give me that mood, then I will do the puja. Understand the importance of ritual, immaterial of your moods. You should understand the importance of rituals. Immaterial of your moods will make your mood swings and confusions irrelevant and redundant. Blessed are those who follow the Sharia. Simply you should know, morning 7 o'clock means forever, whether your body is functioning or your body is gone. If your body is functioning, you will be sitting in Adi Kailasa. If your body is gone, you will be sitting in Jyoti Kailasa. That's all. It's only a campus transfer. That's all. Nothing else. Morning 7 o'clock, you are going to be sitting and doing puja to Sadashiva. In this plane, you may see like you in one face, two hand. In that plane, you will see you like him with all faces and all hands and Sahasra Sirsha Purusha Sahasraksha Sahasrabhat. You should become very clear. You should become very clear. Morning 7 o'clock, I am going to be doing puja as long as this body is breathing in Rajasabha. If this body stops breathing in that Kailash, Jyoti Kailash, that's all. Coming to this conclusion is what I call Charyapada. Coming to this conclusion, then all your mood swing, mood, everything becomes redundant and irrelevant. Understand? The only power your confusion has is your confusion's confidence and its ability to come to the conclusion it can confuse you. If your confusion attacks you 2-3 times and it is not able to confuse you, it will never come to you again. If it can attack you and confuse you, it will continue to come to you again. Again and again and again.